Greetings. This is part 6 in the series, The Legos of God. I've hinted at the position that I am not a young earther. I'm really sorry if that offends you, but I cannot recant my considered position, specifically because it is a considered position. I've been a thinking, believing, born-again Christian for over 40 years. And I believe I have honestly pursued the truth that entire time. What prevents me from being a young earther? Simply the facts and the evidence. I'm about to make a statement which may offend some, but offense is not my intent. I believe the young earth position is driven by a fear of lack of faith. Restated, if you do not believe the universe and the earth is 6,000 years old, you are indirectly or implicitly calling the Bible untrue. And I completely disagree with that conclusion or representation. The 6,000-year-old universe and earth is an interpretation of Scripture. As I said, I do not want to offend. I want to inform, to educate, to encourage, and to glorify God. What is the dominant form of energy used on planet Earth today? Petroleum. Oil. And how did the oil get into the ground? Well, there are two common explanations you might hear if you asked that. Evolution would say dinosaurs evolved at random, died, and decayed to form the hydrocarbons now called oil. Young Earth Christians must claim God created the oil in the ground, as it is, where it is. And those are pretty much the only two thoughts you might ever hear on the subject. But I consider that a false choice. What if God, who created space-time and the laws of physics that define and shape space-time, wanted to limit himself and work within the laws of space-time to provide the resources humanity would need? Keep that in mind, that God is able to decide to restrict himself to working within space-time. I think it is potentially much more amazing that God might have created the process that created the dinosaurs at the right time so that the dinosaurs would become the oil we needed. Have you ever tried to think about it that way? It is not a rule written in stone, but I resonate with the idea that God generally does not violate the laws of physics willy-nilly. And perhaps it highlights two opinions of God differing at polar extremes. Opinion one of God: he is God and can do what he wants, when he wants, how he wants, with no discernible logic or limit. Opinion two of God: he is God and he wants to make evidence of himself visible so that his creation may discern knowledge of him from his creation. I'm not trying to create a new false choice, so I will clearly state there are other refinements, nuances, which can modify these two assertions, creating other positions. Opinion one of God is followed by pagans, theists, and Muslims, who generally operate with a man-made definition of deity or God. Let's look at that opinion first. Because you may be confused that I lump pagans, atheists, and Muslims into the same opinion of God. But the common factor is that all rely on a definition or opinion of God which comes from the mind of man. Pagan religions form a definition of deity or the supernatural from an approach that gave superstitious supernatural explanations for natural observations. And I can hear the atheists already claiming, that is what Christians do. Control your mind and listen. Then maybe you will be able to understand and see. Pagans used their minds and the knowledge available to them to attempt to form explanations, whether about weather, crops, floods, and other events, or about decisions they made. They used their minds to define the unseen, which they believe affected their existence. As such, their definition of deity and the supernatural came from their minds. Atheists and the new anti-theists do not believe in a supernatural which affects their existence. But in their anti-theist arguments, they assume a definition of God and what a God can and, here's their downfall, what they assume must do. You see, an atheist or anti-theist must try to define a deity against which to form straw man arguments. Realize all argumentation and apologetics may do this, but honest argumentation and apologetics tries to avoid this. It endeavors to accurately represent the position being addressed. I find many secular atheists misrepresent Christian position out of ignorance and not intentional fraud. The point being that anti-theists define their mental model of a deity they argue against with their minds. If God is all-powerful, then God is all-responsible. If God created everything, God created evil and is therefore responsible for all evil in the world. This is an unfortunate oversimplification which I have heard over the years from atheists and anti-theists. This is only one example of many of what the mind of man creates, even when those men arrogantly assume they are intellectual and superior in mind. The salient aspect is that atheists and anti-theists define deity with their minds and are therefore limited and biased in their thinking. And what about Muslims? Why do I group them in with pagans and anti-theists? Because any honest, objective examination of Islam's definition of Allah reveals a very interesting matter. The definition and description of Allah in the Quran is superlative, comparative. Allah is the best, smartest, wisest, most, etc. All words comparing Allah to men as a man. And this is exactly how a man defines something unknown, in relation to things that are known and knowable. Opinion 1 of Allah. Allah can do what he wants, when he wants, how he wants, with no discernible logic or limit. When Islam is confronted with confusion in their definition of Islam, they resort to this definition. To swear by anything other than Allah makes it the partner of Allah and is shirk. Allah swears by everything seen and everything unseen, making it the partner of Allah and is shirk. No, no, Allah is not limited by the laws he defined for man. Allah can do what he wants, when he wants, how he wants. Opinion 1 of deity. The deity Allah can do what he wants, when he wants, how he wants, with no discernible logic or limit. So pagans define a deity or deities from their minds. Antitheists define a deity or deities from their minds. Islam and Muslims define Allah from their minds based on effluence from the mind of Muhammad. The opinion 1 of deity. The deity can do what it wants, when it wants, how it wants, with no discernible logic or limit. The Judeo-Christian worldview has an entirely different basis, and I will get to that in the next video of this series. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.